guys! Welcome to this speed build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building a pagoda. An ultra-modern Chinese park. And in the middle of that ultra-modern Chinese park you can find a tower with a pagoda roofs. You know, these roofs with these curved up eaves. These pagoda roofs are very traditional Asian. You can find these roofs in Japan and in China. But the structure you can find in the middle of this park isn't traditional at all. It is a modern interpretation of these pagoda roofs. But not only that, I wanted to make something that could be a Chinese character as well. It isn't a Chinese character. I cannot write Chinese. But I wanted to make something that looks like it could be a Chinese character too. So the combination between the Chinese character shape and the modern interpretation of pagoda roofs. First of all, I wanted to make very clear that this design isn't my own idea. I wish it was my own idea. This build is inspired by this picture. You can see it here. Yes, it has different colors, but these pagoda roofs, the modern style pagoda roofs with all these trees on them. Yeah, you can see it on the picture. I used this as an inspiration. It was a huge inspiration for this build, of course. This isn't really built yet. It's an architectural concept and it's made by Ami Kandalka Onkar. And if you saw my previous video, that crater house for Elon Musk, you recognize the name because that build was inspired by architectural concept from the same guy, Ami Kandalka Onkar. He's Shanghai based and it wasn't on purpose to do two builds inspired by a design of him in a row. I found that picture that I showed you, that inspiration picture for this build, and I thought, oh man, that is so cool, I want to do something with it, it's going to be so challenging but so much fun. So I started building and I was picking out the colors for the entire structure, for the entire tower, because I didn't want to keep it just gray. As you could see on the picture, I wanted to do my own color scheme. And while I was doing that, I wanted to know more about that picture that I found. So I started doing that Google image search, you know, the three first image search. And I found out it's from the same guy. What a coincidence. I think I have a favorite designer now. Ami Kandalka Onkar, check him out because it is the third build that I'm doing that is inspired by one of his designs. I did that house in the rock months ago, was one of his designs as well. But like I said, I found that picture and oh man, it looks so cool and I thought it was something totally different. I never did a park build before and of course I didn't want to do something standard. I wanted to do something totally, out of the box. So I used this picture to create this build for you guys here today. As you can see, I am creating the entire shape here with roofs. Yes, a lot of roofs again. And before we get more into that, maybe you can hear it in my voice. I'm always a bit excited, always a bit happy. But I'm even more excited now because the new expansion pack for the game just got announced. Yay! It's called Snowy Escape. And when you're watching this video on the day when I upload it, it's a Tuesday, but I'm recording this voiceover on a Monday because I have to work tomorrow. And it just got announced on Twitter. And tomorrow, when this video will go online, you can see the new trailer. And it's going to be a snowy expansion pack in an Asian world. How fitting. I started working on this build last week already. And of course, I don't know anything about upcoming packs, or I don't have any other information than you guys. And yeah, what a coincidence. It's going to be an Asian pack with a snowy world, with snowboarding and skiing. And of course, we get more information about it tomorrow in the trailer and in the upcoming weeks. But I'm actually very hyped. I think with a snowy world, an ancient snowy world, there will be huge lots, right? I think so, maybe, fingers crossed. And I love building in the different seasons and I love building in snow, so yeah, I cannot wait. I cannot tell you when the pack is coming out. I cannot give you any more information, but I just wanted to share it with you guys. And talking about building in seasons, I'm building this park, this pagoda, in fall. And you can see it in the colors, of course. I used a lot of orange and red and yellow trees. I will use them later on because you cannot see them right now. I'm building this in Brindleton Bay, the world that came with cats and dogs, and you see these gorgeous trees at the back of this entire build, and yeah, it was just a perfect spot for a Chinese park, or that style I wanted to go for, because this is where the dog park used to be, but you have that water at the back of the lot, with a waterfall and with that hill with these trees. I really searched hard, long and hard, to find the perfect lot for this build. I went to so many different worlds and I never built here before. And in some kind of way, I always tend to try out the same lots where I'm always building on. And I couldn't find a fitting lot for a Chinese style park. So I went to the lots where I normally don't go and I found this one, and it's so perfect with that hill and with these colors at the back. It is a 30 by 40 lot, and my initial plan was to build this on a 64 by 64 lot and make it massive. But in the end, I was very happy that I went for this 30 by 40 lot because I felt I had more than enough space and I didn't want to make the pagoda tower any taller or bigger than it is right now. And I think a 64 by 64 would be way too big for a build like this. So yes, it's a 30 by 40. Of course, I will put it up on the gallery. You can use it in your own build if you want, in your own game if you want. But I recommend you, if you have the cats and dogs pack and if you have a Brindleton Bay, is to use this lot for it. Because I blended it a little bit with the landscape surrounding the lot as well. I picked the same trees and I think it just looks the best on this particular lot. We're way further in the building process, but it was, I think, 2 or 3 minutes long. A couple of minutes ago, I removed the walls underneath the roofs that I used for this structure again. And that method, yeah, I used it so much in a previous build. But when that update came for the game, we can stack windows now. Last September, there came an update for the game. That makes that allows us to stack windows and to freely place indoors. That update came, that method that I always used by, for removing walls underneath roofs by placing in doors on the walls underneath the roofs, sizing them down and raising them up and covering them up. Maybe if you never saw any of my other videos, this sounds a little bit strange, but I talked about it so much before. But well, that method didn't work anymore after that update for the game. But I used that method over here. So I found kind of a solution to still make this method work. You can still place doors on walls underneath roofs, but when you size them, you can still size them down and then the wall still disappears. But normally you want to raise up these doors because you want to cover them up. But when you raise them up, the wall reappears again. So the thing you want to do, you want to use the tool mat. Yes, it is a little bit cheating, but with the tool mat, it's an amazing mat and I used it a couple of times in this build. With the tool mat, you can size down items as well. And normally you can do that when you, after you activated the bb.moveobjects cheat in your game, and you can make items smaller and bigger. You can size them up and size them down with the bracket keys or your keyboard, but it just goes so far and you cannot size them down smaller than a particular size. But with the tool mods from Twisted Maxi, you can size the objects down until you cannot see them anymore. So I did that with the doors in this build that I used on the roofs, on the walls underneath the roofs to make these walls disappear. So yes, it's a little bit cheating, I know, but when I upload this build to the gallery, it doesn't count as CC, so you can just pull it off from the gallery, displace it in your game without that mod installed. And talking about that mod, and maybe you've noticed it already in my build and buy catalog, on the previous videos, I got a lot of comments about the Better Build By mod from Twisted Maxi as well. And I was always a little bit hesitant about mods, and I always wanted to stay within the parameters of the game. But that Better Build By mod, it is so, so amazing, and it saves me so much time. You know, you have these live edit objects, these debug objects. You can find them when you type in a double cheat, and then you get a whole array of debug items. They're not ordered in any kind of fashion. And when you use that mod, the Better Build By mod, they are ordered. Yay! So the debug trees are just in the normal build and buy menu amongst the trees. You can see it here. And it just saves me so much time when I want to search for items amongst all these debug items. And it's not just with the trees, but with fences as well, with statues and with everything. And yeah, it just really saved me so, so, so much time. So every once in a while, you can see an item that looks like it is custom content because it has this little screwdriver thingy on the picture in the build and buy catalog. It's not custom content, it's just a normal item, but it's a debug item, and because it got rearranged amongst the normal build and buy items, it got that marker now. But still, when I'm uploading a build to the gallery, you don't need mods, you don't need the Twisted Maxi Better Build By mod to use this build in your own game. I can copy items, debug items now as well, you know. Normally when you place in a debug item, you cannot copy the item. So if you want to use the item again, you have to go to all the debug items again. And now I can copy items, and I can really recommend you to use that mod, because if you build a lot and if you use the debug items a lot, Little Simsy made a review about it. And yeah, another cool thing, you can go in camera mode while building, while in build mode. These cinematic outros that I'm making, these house tours in the intro as well, I always make them in camera mode in the game. And normally you can only go in camera mode when you are in a live mode. But now I can go in camera mode as well while I am in build mode. So yeah, it makes life a lot easier for me. But let's go to the build. The entire structure of the pagoda tower is already finished, and I decided to go for a different color scheme than what you could see on that inspiration picture. That concrete on the inspiration picture, man, amazing. It looked so stylish, and I think when you build that in real life, it looks epic. But in the game, when you use just one color, sometimes it could look a little bit flat. For example, you can see these amazing, expensive mansions or villas that are completely white in real life. And in real life, they look epic. They look out of this world. But when you make a building completely white, and especially when it's just a box shape, it just looks flat in the game. And I thought, when I used just the gray colors that I had in the beginning of this build, or when I was just finished with the entire structure, it just looked a little bit too bland. And I wanted to go for that look that could be a Chinese character as well. I wanted to make that combination between that inspiration picture, what I had, and that idea that I had in my mind, that I could make it look like a Chinese character too. And I thought, it looked a little bit more like a Chinese character when I picked these white and black colors for the exterior. So that's why I picked them. And I think, yeah, it looks a little bit different than the, just with the gray. I think especially with the color combination, it pops a little bit more of your screen in game. And especially with all these yellow and orange and trees everywhere. When you think what's happening with the Witcher trope, because every time when I'm breathing in, I can hear myself breathing. I have a cold a little bit, no COVID or something. I have a little bit of a cold, so I'm sorry if you can hear that every once in a while in the video. But yes, the entire structure is already finished. I wanted to make some water at the front and at the side of this build. And I wanted to keep that modern look. I didn't want to make... Normally I love making these natural ponds underneath the builds and make a very irregular shape to make the pool look, because I always use pools for that, to make the pool look like a natural pond. But today I wanted to keep it very, very modern. So I went for these, yeah, pools are not really pools. I used a fountain tool for it. And I just went for this simple shape with the rocks in it. These round rocks. I thought they were the most fitting for the build. They came with the Island Living Pack. And I used a lot of these orb fountains. I used them as decorations in the water too. And I used them here and there. Yeah, just as a decorative thing. As well, they came with a spa day. And I think there's something called like Sand Garden Fountain. So I thought it was very fitting for this build. Well, now the entire structure is ready. And of course, the park, if you want to build a park in the game, has to meet a certain requirements. You can see it in the left corner of your screen when you see that house you just clicked on it. There's a red triangle now, and that will disappear when I met all the requirements. There has to be certain benches, toilets, things like that. So I placed a toilet at the back. Didn't want to make it too, yeah, obvious. I didn't want to build a room with a toilet in it. And I thought at a certain point, I realized that I didn't use walls in this entire build at all. And I thought it was kind of a cool challenge. So I didn't want to make rooms. I didn't want to use walls in this entire build completely. So that's why I use one of these pre-made toilet cubicle thingies that you can find in the other parks in the game as well. Here's a place to play chess. And I know chess isn't that Chinese, but this is one of the requirements for a park in the game. You have to have a chess table. Same for a playground equipment. And I thought it would be kind of fun when you're just walking up this tower here. You can work out over there. And at the very, very top, you can find a place to meditate. Because I thought it would be so zen to visit this park with your sim and do some meditation at the very top of this modern interpretation of a pagoda tower. But I think we're almost at the end of this video. Yeah, we're almost at the end. At the end, you can see kind of an outro house tour. It's not really a house tour. Let's just call it an outro. I'm very curious what you thought about this ultra-modern Chinese build. And I'm so curious what you think about the new upcoming pack, Snowy Escape. I can't wait. I really hope to talk to you next Friday during my next video. Have an amazing day. Goodbye.